Maura, Bemidji again. what, seven, eight here, whatever it could
be. Something like that, yep.
What, second time in 3 years you see him in the play at this program? Or is it the third time in?
Second time in three years, the program?
Okay. What stands out to you about Bemidji and what's going to be the key to putting together back-to-back wins, something neither team's been able to do against this year?
Yeah, good games always against Bemidji. I'm excited for this series. You know, it's going to be a physical matchup as always, but they're a different team than maybe you saw in those first couple years that you had mentioned. They have kids that can put the puck in the net, and you know, young goaltending versus Mowat, who was their goaltender for a while there. So a little bit younger in net and a little bit more prolific in the offensive realm, and still very physical. So we know what to expect. As you said, we've seen them a lot, and we're gearing up for a great weekend.
Does that familiarity at all help going into the postseason here, or is it a hindrance? What's your thoughts on that?
You know, I think a lot can be made of watching video and breaking things down, and really what happens when the puck drops is what's most important. It's the team that's going to be ready, like you said, for hopefully a two-game weekend, but potentially a three-game weekend, and that's going to be grueling, especially against a team like Bemidji and the WCHA. I think every team plays a physical style, so that's just something you have to be prepared for. But I think we are, and I think we're excited. There's a lot to that's good when you're familiar with a team too, because you know we've been able to beat them, and we know what, you know, what we can hopefully expose in their game, and we know what we need to sharpen up in ours.
Katka, what's allowed her to really ratchet things up even more than she normally does, start putting the puck in the net?
Yeah, it's nice. I think, you know, who knows, maybe being a senior towards the end of the career, I think it's mostly when the chips are down and her back's against the wall, she usually likes to make plays and look for others, but at times we just need her to shoot the puck because she can shoot it, she can find spots, and you know, when she has confidence in that, she can really help us out. And although she's more comfortable being a playmaker, she can clearly score goals. And when she does, we usually win.
You see the team's mentality kind of transition out into that winner-go-home mentality?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, that's what the playoffs are all about. We've worked really hard all season to get this home ice advantage, to put ourselves in this good spot. And I really like the way we've been playing for the past month or so. So I like the hockey we're playing. I like the energy. I like the focus. I think we've cleaned up a lot of areas of our game. I think we're getting scoring from different areas, whether it's defensemen, different forwards than maybe earlier in the year. Spreading that out a little bit has been good, and scoring on the power play has also been a big lift to us. So I think a lot of things are going well, and we're going to need to, like I said, show up this weekend. That's the biggest thing.
Is this the perfect group for that? Make things simple. As long as they keep winning, they get to keep playing.
Yeah, it's a simple message right there. Absolutely. And I think with a younger team that has battled through a lot of things this year and is putting it together at the right time, I think there's something refreshing about being, you know, 0-0. Everybody's back to zeros here, and it just takes a couple wins. And you get a couple wins, then you're back in the final faceoff. And then when you're there, hey, who knows what could happen. So there's a lot of excitement, a lot of opportunity in front of us, and I know our players are ready to go.
You've said a couple times when we talked about Bemidji this season that they're not maybe the Bemidji that was here in your first year, kind of the more defensive kind of muck it up style. They're getting closer to the style you want to play, but it feels like even in the games this year, getting to your style has been somewhat of a challenge. Is there a trick? Is there something you picked out to getting to maybe those games that you played against Ohio State where you can get up and down the ice?
Yeah, so back in the earlier days, I think Bemidji would settle for the dump and chase, and now they don't. They're going to hold on to it. They're going to make entry plays. They're going to attack the goalie aggressively. So that's the change. The same game plan for them, though, remains. I mean, Jim's a good coach over there, and they have a very defensive game plan where they're going to bring five back on the back check, and they're going to set up in a box, and it's going to be very frustrating to get shots through. So shot selection, creativity in our offensive schemes, good entry plays, things like that, and I think puck possession will be big, and that'll be the challenge because they're big, strong kids on Bemidji's team. So the longer we can hold on to the puck and keep moving and stay off the walls, things like that, the more we can do what we like to do.
You planning anything as a team for tonight's game?
Well, it's so late.
You have to stay up late tonight, right?
I know, absolutely. We'll be up late, but I think we'll be in our respective homes and apartments watching it in our PJs, so should be an exciting one.
Has it been fun just as a program, I mean, not only with Maddie and Sid, but just with so many different countries represented in your room to kind of go through this tournament and watch everybody that's come through this program?
Yeah, it's been awesome. This is my first experience as a UMD coach with the Olympics, and you know, it's fun to be able to turn on any game and watch kids that you coached or kids that you didn't, but are UMD alums, and we couldn't be more proud of all of them and all of the success that they've had. Just being an Olympian is a huge achievement in women's hockey. Obviously, that's like our NHL. So for anybody to wear their nation's colors, it's pretty special.
I know you've got the chance at the Worlds to get a gold medal. You know, if Maddie's able to come back next year with an Olympic gold medal, I mean, she's going to get, you know,
something.
Gold or silver.
Yep.
So it's pretty good no matter what happens. But, you know, to have her and Sid too, but to have those two, you know, where you've coached them, mm-hmm. how much does that mean, you know, personally to you?
It's definitely special. To be a part of their journey is special, but it's mostly about them. And, you know, if Maddie can come back as a gold medalist and we get her for 2 years, I can imagine the confidence will be very high in a good way. She's a humble kid. I'm not worried about anything with that, but not only for our program, but for her, for recruiting and things for the university. I mean, that's a big statement, especially in women's hockey, with Canada having won since, you know, 1998, as we keep hearing about. That would be something else.
I haven't seen a starting lineup for tonight's game yet, but Maddie's played, I think, maybe more. I mean, just to get beyond the team, you know, was good, and to get to the centralization, and then to be starting so much in the tournament. What's that progression been like for her, I guess, you know, where maybe a year and a half ago she didn't even think she was going to be on this team.
Right. Yeah, it's been pretty unbelievable, you know, to get her chance at, she was there in December of her sophomore year and then get invited back and on the Worlds team, but played maybe one game, and we weren't sure what was going to happen in the tryout. She made it, and now she's elevated her game to the point where she is their number one goalie, and I think that's tremendous. I think, you know, it's no surprise given the centralization process and being able to play with those guys from September or so on, that's only going to make her better, and her confidence in situations like that just goes through the roof. You saw, you know, from her freshman year to sophomore year here, when it was her net, she just really elevated. And I think, you know, she's probably getting similar experiences there where she's finding out, hey, I am the number one, and she's playing like it too. So it's pretty special for her.